So Matt just walked in. I don't know the fellow's name sitting across from you, Gerald. Hi.
CJ.
CJ? Yeah. I was just going to introduce Matt to everybody. This is Doug, and Tom's to your left, and Gerald, and CJ. It's a small group tonight, but hey, it's how it is, right? Tommy said you guys started in on Chapter 7 last week. Page 89, and he said he just kind of read through the first couple of pages and suggested maybe we start with the beginning of that chapter this week. So I guess that's where we'll start, without further ado. Everybody there? Yeah. I only got a couple notes on this page, but it starts here, Chapter 7, Working with Others. And just so you know, that the last sentence in the previous chapter, on the previous page, said that the next chapter is entirely devoted to Step 12. So Chapter 7 is supposed to be all about Step 12, but I was actually surprised to learn when Jim pointed out that there are directions for Step 1 in this chapter. You know, and some of the other guys I've listened to, you know, they explain to me, they tell me how interwoven everything is in this book. You know, you go back from one spot to another, and it all kind of ties together. But, you know, my way of thinking, you put all the first step directions up in the front of the book because that's where you expect to see them. But it's not. There's directions here in Chapter 7 for the first step, too. Anyway, it starts off here. It says, practical experience shows that nothing will so much ensure immunity from drinking as intensive work with alcoholics. It works when other activities fail. You know, I heard Doug, I guess you're still looking at that book from 1982, made a comment before we started that there aren't any markings in that book whatsoever, no pencil markings, pen, whatever. In my book, those two sentences, I've got them highlighted and underlined in red, you know, just reinforcing the fact to me that, you know, one of the things I remember Jim used to say was that this book is, one, a history book, and it came from those folks' experience. It was not, you know, he used to say it wasn't somebody's doctoral thesis on any of this stuff. These guys actually went out and lived it. And I know I tend to learn stuff best when I experience it for myself. And I know several people that have learned from the school of hard knocks, as they say, you know. Try this, it didn't work. Try that, it did work. And these guys are saying the same thing here. The practical experience, that's how they learned it, you know, through their actually putting into practice. They're telling us that nothing's going to keep us from drinking, you know, so much ensure immunity from drinking as intensive work with other alcoholics. It says it works when other activities fail. And the other thing I've noticed as I read through that, it doesn't say anything about 12-step. It doesn't say that you have to go out and sponsor somebody. It says intensive work with another alcoholic. If you're having a problem wanting to go out and drink and everything, if you're new, what's wrong with calling up your sponsor? You're going to start working and doing this intensive work with another alcoholic, right? Or it doesn't even have to be a sponsor. You know, if you're in a hard spot and everything, get in touch with somebody else you know, and do something with them, you know. See, the problem with all this, you know, if you remember, I'll flip you back in the book a little bit. You know, back on page 23, it said the main problem in the alcoholic center is in his mind, you know. And then I think it was over on, where was it, page 64 or something like that, where it's, no, I'm sorry, 62. Said that selfishness and self-centeredness, that we think is the root of our trouble. Okay, so everything is, all our problems stem from ourself and our self-centeredness. You know, if you look at the end of step four, where they're talking about doing the sex inventory, you know, take a look on page 70. This is something I found. Towards the end of that first complete paragraph on a page. They're going down. I'm sorry, there's two paragraphs. The next to the last paragraph on a page. The paragraph starts up off to sum up about sex. You see that paragraph? Go through there, and about halfway through that, it starts off and it says, if sex is very troublesome, you find where I'm at here?
Yes.
All right, what I've done in my book anyway is right after that comma, I put a little bracket and highlighted the next couple sentences. All right, well, next couple lines, actually. It says here, we throw ourselves the harder into helping others. We think of their needs and work for them. This takes us out of ourselves. And I put another little bracket there and kind of ended that. So I kind of broke that up into an area. And to my way of thinking, if selfishness and self-centeredness is the root of all my trouble, and I start throwing myself harder into helping others because this takes me out of myself, I'm moving away from the problem and moving more towards the solution.